Hey guys, this is David Kwan here. In this video, I'm going to talk about polygamy. It's a video I felt very necessary to do simply because I started talking a lot about gay marriage recently, and I see all these debates happen, people who are against gay marriage. A lot of the arguments, one of the first arguments they bring up is about polygamy, which I found really odd because I see the debate about gay marriage and the debate about polygamy as two separate things. And I've always argued that these are two separate debates. Just because gay marriage is legalized doesn't automatically mean we're going to start considering polygamy. And just because polygamy is legalized doesn't mean we're going to start automatically condoning, you know, thinking about gay marriage. Two separate things. But it's been brought up so frequently and so immediately too. It's not like we have this long conversation about gay marriage and at the very end, feeling defeated, they bring up, what about polygamy? No, it's like one of the very first arguments that opponents bring up, which is interesting to me. So that's why I'm doing this video, and I'm pretty much doing a separate video on polygamy because that's my point. It's a separate debate. And so in this video, I'm going to be talking about whether polygamy should be legalized or not, and you'll notice that I'm not even going to mention gay marriage or gay equality or gay rights whatsoever. Because it has nothing to do with this debate. The two are totally separate debates. Okay? So that's been my point, and here's me kind of proving that point or demonstrating that point. Alright, so let's talk about polygamy. Why shouldn't polygamy be legalized? Well, for one, it depends on how we're defining polygamy. I'm assuming if you're against polygamy, you're against polygamy because of how we normally conceptualize polygamy, and that's what's normally practiced in history and what's mostly practiced now in societies that condone polygamy, such as Saudi Arabia. So in Saudi Arabia, what kind of polygamy is it? It's a polygamy where men can have multiple wives, but women can't have multiple husbands. That's blasphemy. That's blasphemous for Saudi Arabians, and that's illegal. So it's sexist. It's totally discriminatory kind of polygamy. And that's kind of the polygamy that majority of people are talking about. This polygamy where half of the population is discriminated against. And it's sexist too. Because when you have that kind of discrimination, where men can have multiple wives, but women cannot have multiple husbands, then more wives is kind of like having more property or more objects and being richer and wealthier. So in that regard, you have what are like trophy wives. It's almost like having, well, not really, but you know, maybe saying concubines is too much, but it's kind of getting to that level where there's total sexism going on there. So obviously for that reason, polygamy should not be legalized because it's sexist, it's discriminatory, it's harmful for many of the reasons listed above. There's so many reasons why it should not be legalized on that basis alone. Okay? So now the counter argument to that would be, well, okay, that's that kind of polygamy. But what about like actual polygamy where gender neutral? You know? Men can have multiple wives, women can have multiple husbands, and since we're doing, you know, gay people into the mix, you know, gay people can have multiple husbands, you know, maybe there's four homosexuals that want to get married together, maybe there's four transsexual people that want to get married together. Why shouldn't we legalize that? So that's a more complex question. It's also highly unrealistic, but all right, let's go along with it. Here's the thing. In that kind of scenario where, you know, multiple people are getting married, and gender has no basis whatsoever, and sexual orientation has no basis whatsoever. If that's the kind of marriage it is, and it's totally like, there's no harm in it, and it benefits the society as a whole overall because it, you know, gives more rights to people who are polygamy and a whole bunch of stuff. If everything is positive in this polygamy, I personally see no reason whatsoever to deny that. Yeah, that's right. I would be okay with polygamy if that was the case. So Yeah, now you got me in the trap. Oh my gosh, he's for polygamy. Oh, see, this is what I've been arguing that, you know, you, whatever. But that if is a big, big if, and highly, highly unlikely. I don't think that's possible, even. That's a scenario that's just out there. I don't think it's even ever happened in society. Maybe I can be proved wrong, but that kind of polygamy is hard to ever happen, and that's because of this one reason. Now, human beings are jealous creatures. I would like to refer to this TV show. It's a reality show. It's called Sister Wives. And this family is Mormon. So there's this guy who has a wife, but has sister wives. They're not legally wives per se, but he brought more women into the family and the children of those women into the family, and he makes more children with those more women. And so they're considered family. So in a sense, he has three wives. One is a legal wife, and two more are sister wives. Now, this is not the picture of this happy, awesome family. There's still a lot of harms going on here because of jealousy. The major conflict in this theme, and this conflict comes again and again and again and again, is because of jealousy. And there's a lot of emotional pain and conflict and confusion that come along with this jealousy. His first wife feels pain because now he needs more than her to have a family. So, like, she loves the other sister wives, you know? She loves these women. But at the same time, you can't deny the jealousy that happens when he spends more time with these other women. When that happens, you know? And these other women, of course, they're jealous because they're not their first wife. They're not considered as legal wife, whatever. There is a woman that came before her and before her. There's pain among the woman. There's pain among the children. Because now they're confused, you know, they don't know. There's a separate family that's considered their family, but then it's because there's this confusion. And this is bound to happen whether it's one woman with multiple husbands, or one gay guy with multiple husbands, or one lesbian with multiple wives. This pain is bound to happen. It's not optimal. It's actually bound to cause so much problems. And even if jealousy was not the case, the ability to have multiple wives or multiple husbands means you're financially able to do so. So in that case, we're creating a social class where this is more, you know, we're having a case where it's kind of like how slavery was back in the days. When slavery was legal in America, in the South, majority of people did not own that many slaves. Majority of white people had like one or two slaves, if that. And then there were like these gigantic families that had 100 slaves in their farm or their cotton farm or whatever. And so these people with one or two slaves looked up to these people like, oh my gosh, I wish I was rich enough to own more slaves. So it had slaves as property. When you have a situation like this polygamy, you're viewing your wives or your husbands as more property, as more increasing of wealth. That's why in a society like Saudi Arabia, having four wives is a sign of prestige. It's a sign of social status. I think that's wrong. I think it's really just awkwardly bad to have a society where you are more socially in a high class just because you have more husbands or wives. And so that's another reason, again, because of jealousy, because of social class issues, even if, like, we can't ever have this perfect polygamy that is more beneficial than the cost of having, than the allowing of polygamy. That's why I don't think polygamy should be legalized, because it poses too much more confusion, it poses more harm, and just more overall, it creates a society where our ideas become twisted into thinking that, you know, the more people we have as property, that the wealthier we are. That concept just totally irks me. And that concept is totally, like, unethical to me. And so as long as that concept is like that, it plays out like that, polygamy cannot be accepted. And that's why it shouldn't be legalized.